Hello everyone, welcome to SV Union High School and Junior College. Our subject today is EVS 2 Standard 5. Let us discuss chapter number 6, Stone Age and Stone Tools. This is part 1 of this lesson, children. In this lesson, we are going to discuss 6.1 types and forms of tools according to the types of task. 6.2 Stone Age Tools. Let us begin with the first topic. 6.1 Types and Forms of Tools according to the type of task. We do many activities in our day-to-day life for which we use small and simple things to get our work done easily. Like if we have to dig something out of the ground, we may use a strong twig, dried stick, or a thin rod of iron or a steel rod, etc., depending on the type of the task that is to be done. The following are some of the factors that determine our choice of tools. Like first one, availability of resources. Whatever is available nearby us, where we are, it depends on where we are. Second one is minimal use of time and energy. Energy and time should be saved and we should be able to do that work very easily. We should be able to complete our task easily. Maximum efficiency. And fourth one is skill of handling tool which is acquired through practice. Ape-like monkeys or chimpanzees also use sticks or stones to break seeds and nuts or to bring the ants out of the anthill. The evolving man used tools like bones, stones, dried twigs and sticks. He had the skill of constant and detailed observation, experimentation and inborn imagination. So even man, with the help of his imagination, with the help of his experiments, he learnt where different types of tools are to be required to be used. Due to his day-to-day experience and various observation and his inborn imagination, humans had learned that they could sharpen various rods, bones, sticks and stone into tools to carry out the task more efficiently and easily. With all his experience, he learned to give various shape to these bones and sticks and iron rods and stones, etc. And he gave them desired shapes to various objects so that he could, according to his needs and requirements, he started giving shape to various objects to make different types of tools. Now, in the previous lesson also, we have learned that Homo habilis made stone tools. So, it is believed that Homo habilis made stone tools as well as the tools from other materials. But of all the tools made by human thousands of years ago, only stone tools are found today. Tools made from bones are rarely found. None of the tools made from twigs and sticks are found, as these materials cannot remain for a long time. They get decomposed easily. The stone tools found with the remains of Homo habilis prove this. So, from the period from which mainly these stone tools are found was known as the Stone Age. The Stone Age is divided into three periods on the basis of the shapes and types of tools that were found. First is the Old Stone Age or the Paleolithic Age. Paleo means old and lithos means stone. Middle Stone Age or Mesolithic Age. Meso means middle. New Stone Age or Neolithic Age means neo means new. Now let us see all these stages one by one. First is the Old Stone Age or Paleolithic Age. The Homo habilis made tools using percussion techniques. Now, what is percussion technique? It involves beating or striking one large stone against the other to obtain stone flakes. This was called as percussion technique. And which are the types of tools they made? For example, choppers with the sharp edge on one of its side, used for breaking nuts and bones. He used the flakes of the stones produced while shaping the tools for scraping meat from the hide of animals, for chopping meat and for other foodstuff, for sharpening wood stick, etc. By observing the type of tools that he made, it indicated that Homo habilis had not yet learned to hunt. Flakes of stone would be produced while shaping his tools. He used the flakes for scraping out meat and chopping meat and other foodstuff, for sharpening wood stick, etc. Tools like hand axe and cleaver were made by Homo erectus, are more proportionate and symmetrical than the choppers made by Homo habilis. Homo erectus could mentally visualize his tools even before he actually shaped it. For example, the hand axe and the cleaver, which were more proportionate and symmetrical, and the chopper made by the Homo habilis. He used antlers to obtain stone flakes and further sharpened its edges by scraping off smaller pieces to make scrapers. This shows that Homo erectus was using different tools for his different tasks that he was doing. And with his improved tools, Homo erectus could have greater variety of food because he could now hunt all different types of big and small animals. They included mainly deer, bison, rabbits, etc. Homo sapiens changed the technique of obtaining long and narrow blades of stone. He made various implements like the knife, scrapers, borers, chisels, etc. From these long blades, he also began to use ivory and rare stone of quartz variety for making tools and other articles. Homo sapiens made a great change and progress in gaining knowledge of his surrounding and the environment, and in the techniques of making tools and obtaining food. This helped him to stay in one place for a longer period of time. They started living in groups and they started building huts and living there for a longer period of time. Homo sapiens began to live in groups and they also started building huts and lived in them. They started celebrating various festivals, and many artistic objects and cave paintings created by Homo sapiens were found in the excavation. It was a possibility that during this the festivals that they celebrated, Homo sapiens would have objects painted on the walls of the caves. They had started using ornaments to decorate themselves, like beads, from the time of Homo sapiens, made of shells, bones and animal teeth have been found. Thus, the beginning of human culture go back to the old Stone Age. Remains of the old Stone Age tools from this age were found in many places, from Kashmir to Tamil Nadu. Very few fossils of humans are found in India. Fossils of human skull and the collarbone of women have been found near Hathnora, a village in Madhya Pradesh on the banks of river Narmada. Also, fossils of skull of child from the old Stone Age was found at the village near Puducherry. Human remains of old Stone Age man have been found in Afghanistan and Sri Lanka as well. In Maharashtra, old Stone Age sites are found at Gangapur in on the banks of river Godavari near Nashik and Chirki Nivasa in Pravra Basin near Nivasa. The above slide shows us an old Stone Age cave painting from Bhimbetka. I hope you have understood this explained part, children. We shall continue this lesson in my second video. I request all of you to go through the lesson, read the lesson carefully. We shall continue in the next part. Thank you and take care of yourself.